His trophy is given as RC. Right? So how much is tau? 1 kilo into 1 nano.
1 microsecond.
Nano means 10 to the power of minus 9. So 1 microsecond. Okay? So tau is given as 1 microsecond. Right? Suppose that this Jena diode is not there. What is there in the problem? There is nothing. It is simple like your RC low pass filter circuit when a pulse input is given to you. Yes or no? So what is the first question that is given here? Find out output voltage at t is equal to capital TP, that is equal to 1 microsecond. What is tau is equal to? 1 microsecond. At V naught of t, at t is equal to TP is equal to 1 microsecond, what is my output voltage is? Even without doing, I can tell directly what is my output voltage is. What is my output voltage is?
63.2% of.
Very good. Tau is nothing but the time taken for reaching your output by 63.2% of the maximum value. Maximum value is 10. What is 63.2% of maximum value? That is 6.32 volts. No. And what is the voltage across the Jena diode that is given? 7 volts. Okay. So only thing is you should know one important point regarding the Jena diode. What is the purpose of a Jena diode? Jena diode purpose is to
voltage
breakdown.
Okay.
So it is going to have a breakdown voltage, which is normally used to provide a constant voltage. So and only when your Jena diode is in the breakdown region, then only it will be acting as a regulator. Regulator means giving constant voltage. So when your Jena diode is in the breakdown region, then what is voltage provided by your Jena diode? 7 volts, constant, okay? If your Jena diode is not in the breakdown region, then it is in the open circuit, no current, no element at all. Only thing is Jena diode comes into the picture only when it is operated in the breakdown region, okay? For operating in the breakdown region, the voltage across this need to be applied more than this, okay? Then automatically it is going to sustain a voltage which is 7 volts, which is always constant. That is the point regarding the Jena diode, which you might have learned in your earlier classes. Right? Only thing is whether Jena diode is in the breakdown region or not. When it is going to come to the breakdown region, when the voltage applied is more than the breakdown voltage. If it is in the breakdown region, then the voltage across the Jena diode is 7 volts. Okay? Can a voltage across two parallel elements be different? Can the voltage across two parallel elements be different? So voltage across two parallel elements should be same. If my voltage across the Jena diode is 7 volts, what do you say about the voltage across the capacitor? 7 volts
seven
only.
Volt.
Okay. But as long as my voltage across the capacitor is less than 7 volts, then its voltage is given by capacitor only. But when once my voltage across the capacitor is exceeding the so-called 7 volts, then my Jena diode voltage comes into the picture, then automatically my voltage across the capacitor is going to be 7 volts. That is the only point. So the second question is, what is the second question? What is the second question?
At
V naught of t.
TP equal to 2 microseconds.
At t is equal to TP is equal to 2 microseconds. My output voltage equation at t is equal to TP. At t is equal to TP, it is given as Vp is equal to V into 1 minus e power minus TP by tau. So when Vp is equal to 2 microseconds, tau is 1 microsecond. So what is the value? 10 into 1 minus e power minus 2. How much is the value?
8.64.
Roughly. Very good. 8.64. Okay. So when my output voltage across the capacitor is 8.64, what do you say about your Jena diode? Jena diode is getting into the breakdown region, then its voltage is going to getting into the picture, then my output voltage is no more going to be 8.64, it is in simply 7 volts. Okay, because the time at which you are considering is 2 microseconds. Okay. Right. So your output voltage is not as you are calculated as 8.64. But because there is a Jena diode which will getting into the breakdown region with which it is going to acquire a voltage 7 volts, as no two parallel elements can have different voltages, my voltage across the capacitor is also going to be 7 volts. Right? Okay, then what is the third bit? Third bit is find current through Zener diode. Current IZ at T is equal to TP is equal to 2 microseconds. At T is equal to 2, TP is equal to 2 microseconds, what is the status of your Zener diode?
7 volts.
7 volts.
That means what is voltage across the capacitor?
7 volts.
So when my voltage across the capacitor is a constant, what is the current through the capacitor? You know that your I is equal to C into dV by dt, yes or no? Zero. I is equal to C into dV by dt. When my voltage across the capacitor is constant, what is my current is zero. When zero. Your current is zero, then what is the Zener diode current is given by?
Zero.
This voltage is 10. No. Current through the capacitor is 0 amperes. So what is the current through the Zener diode, IZ? IZ is given by this voltage 10. Vi is nothing but 10 volts minus this voltage is 7 volts divided zero. By 1. Okay, 3 milliamps. So my IZ is given as, my IZ is given as 10 minus 7 by 3 kilo ohms, that is milliamperes. So how much is this? How much is the resistance that is given? 1 kilo. So it is 3 milliamperes. Okay, right? Isn't that the question is interesting, that your idea of whether you know this equation or not, isn't that the basic equation that you have learned long back ago, even in your plus two itself? Yes or no? Then lastly, what is that your last problem is, at what T, okay, at what T is equal to TP, your Zener diode will be in the breakdown region. Okay, Zener diode will be in the breakdown region. So that means your output voltage is now given as 7 volts. Yes or no? 10 into 1 minus e power minus TP by tau is 1 microseconds. Can you find out what is your TP is? Yes or no? Only when your output voltage is more than 7 volts, then only your Zener diode will be getting into the breakdown region. Right? So until my output is going to be 7 volts, what is my TP is going to be? From here, can you find out what is your TP is? My TP, I can write it as 0.7 is equal to 1 minus e power minus TP. Okay. Then I'll bring here. So 1 minus I'll write here 0.3 is equal to e power minus TP. Okay. So e power TP is equal to, e power TP is equal to 1 by 0.3. So TP is equal to ln 1 by 0.3. What is my TP is? Roughly 1.2 microseconds. Okay. So what is the meaning here is, until your TP is equal to 1.2 microseconds, your output voltage across the capacitor is less than or equal to 7 volts. But when once the TP is more than this 1.2 microseconds, then your voltage across the capacitor is going to exceed the 7 volts. Then your Zener diode comes into the picture in providing the constant voltage, which is 7 volts. Okay? So this is a simple problem.